the messengers of the Heavenly Father. You are blaspheming the Holy Ghost. But starting with those who claim to be in these other camps, they receive the greater damnation, the greater judgment. Because you're calling it an unclean thing that we come out here to do. This is the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 41. And why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, and perceivest not the beam that is in thine own eye? So these are the camps. They don't see the mote that is in the eye. They don't see that they're attempting to keep the commandments of the Heavenly Father, the Passover, and the goddamn strip club, calling themselves high priests, calling themselves saying the Hebrews, and these are not the words of the Heavenly Father. You will receive the greater damnation for that bullshit that you're spewing, along with these other doctrines and so-called religion, and ultimately so-called white man, because he's pushing all this bullshit out. But as it is written, judgment will start at the house of God, which is starting with you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, and those who claim to be teachers to the nation of Israel today. So this is what we're out here for. We're not out here for you goddamn scoffers. We could care less what you think, what you say, what you do. We're going to continue in the doctrine of the elders and apostles of GMS. We're going to tell you the truth about the Holy Scriptures. Come out here and teach. We're going to do that until this goddamn kingdom the wickedness is burnt up. Luke 6:41. Why beholdest thou the mote that is in thy brother's eye, but perceivest not the beam that is in thine own eye? So this is what the Sicarii is doing. You need to take out the beam out your goddamn eye first, before you talk about the elders and apostles of GMS are teaching unclean things. And you're blaspheming the Holy Spirit, the Bukkah Kodash. This is the book of Mark, chapter 12, verse 33. This is the book of Mark, chapter 12, verse 29, and Yahweh Shai, and verse 28. And one of the scribes came, having heard them reasoning together, and perceiving that he had answered them well, asked them, what is the first commandment of all? Verse 29, and Yahweh Shai answered him, the first of all the commandments is, hear, O Israel, the Lord Yahweh, our God, is one God. So it's not about what so-called religion is teaching. It's not about philosophy. This is about the doctrine of Yahweh B'Hashem Yahushai. This is not about you goddamn scoffers. We're out here to teach the lost sheep of our people. Those that are stuck in religion and these other philosophies. So Yahweh Mashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, he said the first commandment is here Israel, that is possessive. The Lord our God, that is possessive. is one God. Verse 30, and thou shalt love Yahweh thy God with all thy heart, and all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment. Because you're supposed to love your God, so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, with all your mind, with all your heart, with all your soul. And your mind, your heart is your mind, which is lava in the Hebrew. Your soul, which is what moves you, what gives you, what animates you to move, to perceive, to see, to taste. These are the things that guide you. The spirit. And the more the world, which is the nafash, your soul, in the Hebrew. And all your strength, that is ma'at, your behemoths. Your will, your anger. These are the things that are part of the first commandment. A lot of you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans, you're weak, and you're goddamn cowards. So why are you to call out, not just you other camps, we're calling out of people's bullshit. Why are you so goddamn scared? Yahushua Mashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, he said, does not the grass even feed the flowers in the goddamn grass? How much less you? Says in the book of Ecclesiastes that even the field, even the king is fed by the field. So ultimately, even slaves have to be fed. So why are you worried about those things? So-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans. It even says in the book of Revelation, one of the horsemen had a pair of balances. That is talking about a yoke that was put on our people, to our African-American fathers during the time of slavery. If you go into the Greek, it's talking about a yoke or chains, things used in slavery, or Hispanic brothers. This is what happened to our people. We had chains. Now we have chains on our mind. This is why you so-called Black, Hispanic, and Native Americans have to strive for their meat to do the will of your Heavenly Father. Not meat that perishes. Now things that come, that have an end. Like food, clothing. These are the least of the things. You have to search out this wisdom. The wisdom of this book. What is going to happen in the future? According to the prophecy. According to what the prophets are coming out and telling you. Concerning Babylon the Great, which is America. Mystery of Babylon. And how you so-called Black and Hispanics have been and had the same history. Servitude, subjugation, slavery. Now it's a mental slavery. Why did that happen? Deuteronomy chapter 28 will tell you. We denied to keep the commandments of our Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and Yahushai. That is the name of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was a so-called Black man. He was not no goddamn cracker. We are the same people. We're in these last days before World War III happens throughout the whole earth. That is Armageddon. And the whole nation, the majority of the Israelites are here in America today. This is their wedding that has been furnished with guests, pursuant to Matthew chapter 22. And the Heavenly Father is separating the sheep from the goat. Especially in these times. So it says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 50, verse 33, thus saith Yahweh, the children of Israel, so-called Hispanics, and the children of Judah, the Judites, the real Jews, the black Jews, so-called Negroes, or brothers, were oppressed together, and all took them captives, and held them fast. They refused to let them go. Why? Because we build the society. We keep the society afloat. We give the people the flavor. We give the society flavor. We are the soul of the earth. We have the rhythm. We have the creativity. We are the hardest workers. We are the smartest. This is why if you go into the history of America, our so-called Negro brothers, they created most of the things that the goddamn this red devil took and patented as his own. Because they are ahead, they are our leaders. Mainly the tribe of Judah, which is made up of these, of the so-called Haitians, African Americans, Jamaicans, Dominicans. These are the strength of the nation. We are the backbone, so-called Hispanics. This is why the so-called white man likes to separate us, likes to cause divisions, cause us to hate each other. Because you have to have a head, you have to have a tail. This is why our Judite brothers, the so-called Negroes, are oppressed the most, because they are the head of the nation. We are the backbone. So-called Hispanics. But why do you resist the Holy Ghost, the Ruach HaKodesh? Like it says in the book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 39. This is the book of Acts, chapter 7, verse 51. Ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Ghost. As your fathers did, so do ye. So-called black, Hispanic, and Native American. How long are you going to resist the truth? Resist the wisdom of this book? Resist the things that please the Heavenly Father? Resist the way of truth. As your fathers did, so do ye.
Okay. So again,
going back to Mark chapter 12, starting with verse 33. Where did I leave off? Verse 30. Thou shalt love the Lord Yahweh with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. That is the first commandment. The second is namely this. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. This is why Yahushua Mashiach said, you forgive your neighbor 7 times 7. You're supposed to forgive your neighbor or the children of your people, your own people. And everyone in the world forgives and helps their own people, except you so-called black, Hispanic, Native Americans. You're supposed to love your people as you love yourself. It's not about color. This is about nationality. This is about showing love to your own people. This is what you so-called black, Hispanic, and Native Americans do not do. But these other nations, that's exactly what they do. This is another reason why we know who God's chosen people are. Because it says in Deuteronomy chapter 28, you will have an evil eye towards your brother, towards your father, towards your mother. Mark 12 and 31, and the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Verse 32, and the scribe said unto him, well, master, thou hast said the truth. There is one God, there is none other but He. This is the point right here, verse 33. And to love Him with all the heart, with all the understanding. So you have to have all the understanding. You can't be lukewarm, like it says in the book of Revelation. Neither hot nor cold, because He's going to spew you out. Supposed to love Him with all your understanding. And the understanding is not in Christianity. It's not in Catholicism. It's not in religion. It's not in philosophy. It's not in these other doctrines. It's not in Islam either. Those things are man created. When Yahushua Mashiach, who you call Jesus Christ, He said, you will know my doctrine because it speaks of me and the Heavenly Father. So the doctrine is the Holy Scriptures, which is the inspiration of the Heavenly Father given unto men. In these latter days, unto the elders and apostles of GMS, where He will teach our people. And it says, Mark 12 and 33, and with all the soul, with all the strength, to love his neighbor as himself is more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. That is the end all be all. To teach your people the truth, teach them to love one another, forgive each other, show them the light, show them the prophecies. What is going to happen to Babylon the Great? Not to take the mark of the beast. That is more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. So you know the camp Sicari. You're caught up in priesthoods, in titles. Talking about, we're going to make offerings, burnt offerings in the kingdom. We're all going to be perfect in the kingdom. And 2/3 that do not believe in this gospel of the kingdom, that salvation is for you only, you so-called black, Hispanic, Native Americans, will get burnt up in Babylon the Great by nuclear missiles. We will see you in the kingdom after you're reborn by us. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 14. So this is what you had back then. You had so-called scribes and Pharisees that were adding to the law, talking about they're making long prayer, talking about they pray 7 times a day. That's not what this is about. This is about mercy and grace, showing mercy to your people, forgiving your people, loving your own people, teaching them the truth. And Yahweh is God. Yahweh Shai is Mashiach. That is who you call Jesus Christ. We are the children of Israel, so-called Black, Hispanic, Native Americans. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 and verse 14. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of Yahweh, for they are foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned. Starting with Sakari and you other camps, you're spiritually discerned. Caught up in genealogies, talking about you're a master in Israel, you're a teacher. You're teaching, but you're breaking willingly the commandments. These are those that are spiritually discerned. 2/3 of our people are spiritually discerned. Walk around like goddamn zombies. Following after the ways of these other nations. You need to repent before you get burnt up in Babylon the Great, along with these other nations. And the way in the goddamn the devil that Bible speaks of, the so-called white man, the children of Esau. Verse 15, but he that is spiritual judgeth all things. So we have to judge all things, including starting with those who claim to be teachers in Israel. You are the camps. IUIC, Sakari. This is who we're focusing on. We're not focusing on you goddamn scoffers. We're not focusing on these dead religions. We're not focusing on that. We're here to do keep the charge of the Heavenly Father, which is to teach our people, and to be out here as a witness unto all nations. Verse 16, for who had known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him, but we had the mind of the Mashiach, because Yahweh Shai Mashiach, he knows those that are his. This is why he said, wide is the way unto destruction, the straight and narrow path unto salvation. And he also says in another time, the salvation is of the Jews, the Israelites. So this is not talking about everybody. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 6. Your glory is not good, will ye not, that a little leaven it the whole lump. So this is why we are here to separate ourselves from the other nations, from the other philosophies, starting with your other camps. Because you're corrupting the doctrine, the truth of the Heavenly Father. This is why we give double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS. And they had the 100% truth. Because leaven, you see the same example happening during the time of the Romans. You had these Pharisees, the rulers of the people, teaching the multitude to be hypocrites. You see the same thing happening today. This is why we have the mind of Hamashiach, because we're staying in the doctrine, in the things that were commanded, in this charge. And the little leaven leavens the whole lump, which is why unity camps are not the way. lining up like the likes of Carl did with Marsharal, Yasharala, which is a conglomerate of camps, yet the doctrine is opposite unto theirs, which is why they separated from them. These things are off. These are leaven. This leaven is a representation of an outside influence. When you make a cake without leaven, it is pure, it's undefiled, it doesn't have any outside influence. So a little leaven leavens a whole lot. That is what leaven represents. When you make bread, you make it without leaven. It doesn't have anything corrupting it. So this is why we're calling out your other camps. This ain't about your other nations. This ain't about Esau. This is about calling our people back to repentance, to the truth, to your nationality. You are the Israelites that the Bible speaks of. Starting with the men. We have to get the men back in order. These so-called black Hispanic Native Americans gotta stop being so goddamn scared. Stop being cowards. Where is your faith? Yahusha Mashiach, that's what he told Peter. You have little faith. This is Matthew chapter 16, verse 6. Says the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 6. Then Yahushai said unto them, take heed and beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees. Pharisees was a sect of those who believed in the resurrection. Sadducees, they did not believe in the resurrection. So Yahushai Mashiach, who called Jesus Christ, he said, beware of their doctrine. Beware of these other camps and their doctrines, which have been leavened, have an outside influence. They are not coming out of the words of the Heavenly Father, talking about writings of Paul and Hebrews are not of the Heavenly Father. This is how you know the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. This is how you know what the truth is. This is how you know how it's undefiled, when you hear the words that are spoken, and they're spoken according to the doctrine, which was delivered, starting with the elders and apostles, GMS. Matthew 16 and 7, and the reason among themselves say, it is because we have taken no bread. Verse 9, verse 11, how is it that you do not understand that I spake not to you concerning bread, that you should beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees? Verse 12, them understand that they know how that he bade them not beware of the leaven of bread, but of the doctrine of the Pharisees and of the Sadducees. And you see the same thing happening today. This is how you know these other religions are not the truth. This is how you know these other camps are off. They're defiled. They're full of leaven, malice, hypocrisy. Let's go back to 1 Corinthians chapter 5. First Corinthians chapter 5, verse 9. I wrote unto you in an epistle, not to company with fornicators. So you're supposed to separate from these other doctrines, these other philosophies, these other so-called religions.
Verse 10.
Verse 10.